Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, dear brothers and sisters. This is your brother Omar Suleiman. Ramadan Mubarak. In Ramadan, we're going to be tested over and over and over again. You're going to be tested while you're driving to work. You're going to be tested sometimes by your family members, by your friends. People will test you. And you have to understand that although the shayateen are not as effective in Ramadan, you still have some very active human shayateen that will try to push you. Now, we know many ahadith where the Prophet ﷺ talked about the way that a person should respond when he's fasting, if he's insulted, or if someone becomes aggressive with him, or if he sees something he doesn't like. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said also, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban." Whoever fasts Ramadan with iman and with ihtisab, with faith and with seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's reward, with accountability, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدْمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him for all of the sins that came before. We don't have to look at those ahadith where the Prophet ﷺ talked about things that break your fast and just say, well, I need to avoid that. We should also see them as greater opportunities for reward. Meaning what? When that person offends you, when you go through that, when you go through that time in Ramadan or that time in your day of fasting where someone is trying to push you, or you feel like you're about to do something that's going to compromise the reward of your fast, don't just say to yourself, this might ruin my fast, but also say that this is an opportunity for me to elevate my fast. And what that means is, Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, he said sometimes a person may be offended and would fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say that he's fasting, and that would be greater than the reward of one who recited the entire Qur'an within a day of fasting. Why? Because when you recited the Qur'an was beautiful. Although it requires effort and it's a month of Qur'an, we don't want to underestimate that. But at the same time, when someone gets aggressive with you, it shows you whether or not that Qur'an is having an effect on you, whether or not it's actually changing your personality. So this is a test of the effectiveness of that. And so use those opportunities where people test your patience, where people try to break your fast, as an opportunity not only to keep your fast, salim, not only to keep it healthy, but at the same time to seek elevation in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us, to accept our fasting, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to allow us to fall into anything that would compromise our fast. Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Of the symptoms of a hard heart, and this is especially relevant in our times, of the symptoms of a hard heart is to be selfish about yourself and not care about the rest of the ummah. If you are disconnected from the reality of the ummah, if you go to sleep at night and you couldn't care less about the massacre that just happened